Hello friends, this is the first video I am going to prepare under personal development. I have selected one of the best books in the world and my most favorite book to start with. Let me first introduce an author of this book, Peter F Drucker. He was a writer, teacher and consultant. His 34 books have been published in more than 70 languages. He founded the Peter F Drucker Foundation for non-profit management and counseled 13 government, public service institutions and major corporations. Coming back to the book, most of us will have to learn manage ourselves. We will have to learn develop ourselves. We will have to place ourselves where we can make the greatest contribution. But the question is how to do it. You will find an answer of this question in this book, where an author has explained this in steps with genuine practical examples. So let's begin to understand and implement these important steps in our life. A. What are my strengths? This part consists of 4 subparts. 1. Identify your strengths. In simple language, strengths are tasks or actions that you can do well. The only way to discover your strength is feedback analysis. This is an old technique invented sometime in the 14th century. Peter was followed this analysis more than 15 years and explained it in very simple language. Whenever you make a key decision or take a key action, write down what you expect will happen. 9 or 12 months later, compare the actual results with your expectations. Practice consistently. This simple method will show you within a short period of time, maybe 2 or 3 years, where your strengths lie. This is the most important thing to know. 2. Work on improving on your strengths. Feedback analysis will rapidly show where you need to improve skills or acquire new ones. It will also show the gaps in your knowledge and those usually can be filled. 3. Discover your intellectual arrogance and overcome it. Too many people, especially people with a great expertise in one area, are disapproving the knowledge in other areas or believe that being bright is a substitute for knowledge. For example, some first-rate engineers, for instance, tend to take pride in not knowing anything about people. Human beings, they believe that, are too confused for engineering mind. Some human resource professionals, by contrast, often pride themselves on their ignorance of quantitative methods and accounting, but taking pride in such ignorance is self-defeating. It is equally essential to remedy your bad habits, that is, the things you do or fail to do that inhibit your effectiveness and performance. The question is how you will get these habits, and the answer is feedback analysis. For example, a planner may find that his beautiful plan fails because he does not follow through on them. This planner will have to learn that the work does not stop when the plan is completed. He must find out the people to carry out the plan and explain it to them. He must adapt and change it as he puts it into an action. And finally, he must decide when to decide to push the plan. At the same time, feedback analysis will also reveal when the problem is of lack of manners. Yes, manners are the lubricating oil of an organization. It is a law of nature that two moving bodies in contact with each other creates friction. This is also true for human beings. Manners, simple things like saying please and thank you, knowing a person's name or asking after his or her family enables two people to work together. If analysis shows that someone's brilliant work fails again and again as cooperation from others is required, it probably indicates a lack of courtesy, that is, lack of manners. 4. Use of feedback analysis. By comparing your expectations with your results also indicates what not to do. We all have a vast number of areas in which we have no talent or skills. One should waste as little effort as possible on improving areas of low competence. It takes far more energy and work to improve from incompetence to mediocrity than it takes to improve from first-rate performance to excellence. Energy, resources and time should go instead to making a competent person into a star performer. B. How do I perform? Amazingly, some people know how they get things done. But most of us do not even know that different people work and perform differently. Too many people work in ways that are not their ways, and that always guarantees non-performance. A few common personality traits usually determine how a person performs. 1. Am I a reader or listener? The first thing to know whether you are a leader or listener. Only few people know that they are readers or listeners and that people are rarely both. Even fewer know which of two they themselves are. But remember, its ignorance will be too much damaging. To understand this, author has given us two real examples. Example 1. When Dwight Eisenhower was a supreme commander of Allied forces in Europe, he was darling of the press. His conference was famous for his style. In this role, his advisors made sure that every question from the press was presented in writing at least 30 minutes before a conference was to begin. And then Eisenhower was in total command. He was a reader. After 10 years, Eisenhower becomes president. When he became president, he succeeded two listeners, Franklin D. Roosevelt and Harry Truman. Both men knew themselves to be listeners and both enjoyed free of all press conferences. Eisenhower may have felt that he had to do what his true predecessors had done. As a result, he never even heard the questions generalists asked and talked endlessly about something else. He was trying to become the listener and not succeeded. Example 2. A few years later, Lyndon Johnson destroyed his presidency in large measure by not knowing that he was a listener. His predecessor, John Kennedy, was a reader, who assembled a large group of writers as his assistants, making sure that they wrote to him before discussing their memos in person. Johnson kept these people in his staff and they kept on writing. He never understood one word what they wrote. Yet as a senator, Johnson had been superb. The only reason for it was parliamentarians have to be listeners. Few listeners can be made or can make themselves into competent readers and vice versa. 2. How do I learn? Know the fact that schools everywhere are organized on the assumption that there is only one right way to learn and that is the same way for everybody. There are actually different ways to learn. For example, the people like Churchill who learn by writing. Beethoven learn by converting things into sketches. Some people learn by doing and some people learn by hearing themselves talk. Once you learn the things, acting on this knowledge is the key to performance and we can say not acting on this knowledge condemns one to non-performance. To manage yourself effectively, you also have to ask third question. 3. Do I work with people or am I a loner? Some people are best as team members and others work best alone. Some are exceptionally talented as coaches and mentors. As an answer of this question, you must know which kind of person you are. 4. Do I produce results as a decision maker or as an advisor? A great many people perform best as advisors but cannot take the burden and pressure of making the decision. A good many other people, by contrast, need an advisor to force themselves to think, then they can make decisions and act on them with speed, self-confidence and courage. That is the reason, by the way, that the number 2 person in an organization often fails when promoted to number 1 position. The top spot requires a decision maker. And 5. When you can perform well. You need to ask some questions like, do I perform well under stress or do I need a highly structured and predictable environment? Do I work best in a big organization or a small one? The conclusion bears repeating. Do not try to change yourself. You are unlikely to be succeed, but work hard to improve the way you perform. So far, I have explained 2 units of this book out of 7. This is a really great book. This book will help you to unblock your full potential by discovering your strengths, recognizing how you best work with others, and identifying the work environments that are right for you. If you want to learn remaining 5 units, you can buy this book by clicking on the link provided in the description. You can visit my website www.learnandapply.org and recommendation page to get a hard copy of this book as well as other recommendations. Please visit this website, add your valuable comments and subscribe it for regular updates. If you want to read soft copy of this book, you can get it from Kindle store by clicking on the link provided in the description. And again, if you don't like to read at all and still want to get entire knowledge from this book, you can get it from Audible subscription along with 2 free books by clicking on the link provided in the description. Whatever mode you select to get a knowledge is great, but start to read to improve our life and society. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful. Share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve their life. If you want to get updates of such videos, please do not forget to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.